कांग्रेस बिल्कुल ये सिक्योर 87 पोजीशन इन द सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन. सो व्हेन डू यू स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस वन शुड जनरली व्हेन थिंकिंग अबाउट द एग्जामिनेशन व्हाट इज द आइडियल टाइम.
थैंक यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. एक्चुअली टू बिकम ए सिविल सर्वेंट वॉज आवर चाइल्ड हुड ड्रीम. माई फादर एक्चुअली इंकरेज्ड मी अलवेज एंड आई फाउंड द एंथुसियाज्म आफ्टर ग्रेजुएशन एंड आई वॉज वर्किंग फॉर अ मल्टीनेशनल कंपनी इन चेन्नई एंड एट दैट टाइम आई फाइनली डिसाइडेड दैट आई हैव टू गो फॉर दिस एग्जाम एंड आई स्टार्टेड माई प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम दैट.
तो हाउ डिड यू मैनेज यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन between the your working hours?
It's like I knew that the things are going to be difficult, so I always kept my expectations low, and I knew that to crack this exam I will have to do hard work, so I always tried to manage my time. Like I had to do work from 9 to 6, sometimes even after 6 o'clock, sometimes even till 2 o'clock in the night. So whenever I got a little bit amount of time, even if it is 10 minutes or 15 minutes, I tried to utilize it at maximum.
What was the optional paper of the examination and how did you prepare for the optional paper?
I took public administration as my optional and test series, at least test series is required.
Which standard book did you refer for the preparation for the mains and prelims
book? See, I have seen many candidates segregating or separating prelims with mains, but the thing is we have to prepare for the civil services. Failure at any stage will cost you the result. So at any point of time, we need not to separate this. We have certain standard set of books which are required both for prelims and mains. So I used to follow NCERT and Lakshmikant for polity, NCERT for old NCERT for history, again NCERT for geography, and there is one book named G.C. Leon for physical geography. Then I used to follow economics notes of a coaching institute. Current affairs, again, we have to read newspaper daily. Every candidate must read newspaper daily for this exam. And reading newspaper makes the whole process very easy. It mold you to the process. Time, so I always, like I said, I was, my expectations were not high for my results or for my even for my the number of hours I should study. So generally if I say think today, initially it was not more than 3 hours 4 hours, but once I decided to quit job and start preparing for this again in my this attempt, actually I quit job last year, so it was almost 8 to 10 hours daily.
What was your style of preparation? Do you follow timetables, set targets, daily, weekly or monthly, some kind of?
No. I never followed any timetable. After two attempts, I had the overview of what I have to study and most importantly, what I need not to study. So I had a set of books and I had this mentality also that I had created this mind frame that I have to finish this book in these many days and all. So I just followed that. There was no such timetable, not even monthly or weekly. But I was prepared to that I should complete these books at least 1 week or 2 weeks before the exam.
Do you make notes? Do you think it is important, notes making?
It actually depends, because notes making, I consider notes making as art. People who are expert in that thing, they can only do. I also tried many times, but I always failed. Somehow I managed to prepare notes for public administration paper 1 in this attempt.
When you started reading Civil Services Chronicle magazine, and how Civil Services Chronicle magazine contributed to your success?
In my first attempt, actually, because at that time ethics paper was introduced and there was no material available in the market. But Civil Services Chronicle, they published four special edition, and after that I used to follow it regularly. Somehow in between when we get the conceptual clarity on all these things.
So how many newspapers did you read, and how much time did you spend reading newspapers?
I read The Hindu starting from my first attempt till last year, and initially it used to take long time, even sometimes 3 hours, because we don't know what to study, what to read, what not to read. But after 2 or 3 months, I was able to finish it in 90 minutes. And there should not be hurry in reading newspaper also, because if you see the mains question paper, many of the questions are of current nature. So giving ample amount of time to newspaper is also necessary. 90 minutes, 100 minutes are okay. You should also not give more than that. But in that time frame, you can finish newspaper.
Did you join any mock test series, and how you feel that, how important is test series both in prelim and mains?
For mains, I think test series is very much required, because your writing skill matters. If you have knowledge and you are not able to structure it down on the paper, you will not fetch marks. So I joined Chronicle test series in my second attempt and my third attempt also. The best thing about Chronicle test series is, like, for me, it worked as a miracle. It improved my writing skill in my both attempts. Like last year also, I was up to interview. In this attempt, I cleared. My marks in Chronicle test series were same what I got in the final, in final UPSC exams. So my total marks, the kind of marks I was getting in test series, I got same kind of marks in my UPSC examination. Questions paper were of very highest standard, not in terms of different aspect, like the way UPSC asked questions, it was up to that level. So it really helped me to structure my knowledge, analyze the things in a better way, and write it down in a correct manner.
What was your strategies for clearing prelims exam and main exams? Did you follow an integrated approach for preparation of both, or did you prepare prelims and then main separately?
No, that's what I said before. We always focus on civil services examination, not on preliminary or mains. Means any kind of separation will lower your confidence level. But yes, before prelims, 2 months before prelims, our study pattern should change. It should be more of objective nature, multiple choice kind, because the way that particular exam asks questions, our study pattern should be also like that. Like when I was preparing for prelims, means I used to frame questions. Whenever after reading one paragraph, I used to frame some questions, the question which may be asked by UPSC. Again, before mains, my approach was more on analyzing the topics, more on thinking about the pros, cons, suggestions, current examples related to that. So there was no such separation, but before the examination, we had to think according to the demand of that examination.
Did you attempt all questions in your main examination, or you did attempt only those questions that you know perfectly?
No, I attempted all in GS paper 1. I left one in GS paper 2 and paper 3, and I attempted all in GS paper 4. So it was not like if I didn't know the answer, I didn't attempt. I tried to attempt, because if you have the ability to think, ability to analyze the kind of question UPSC asks, which are generally in current nature, you can relate it to something happening around the world or around India in some previous time, and your analytical thought will always give you some kind of answer that we can write it.
Did you write the answer in a paragraph or in the bullet points?
No, I followed both. Like again, I have heard many people saying that we should write in point format or paragraph format, but we should always know different question has different demands. There could be some question asking what are the negatives and positives of a particular event. There you can write in point. These are the positive, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negatives, 1, 2, 3, 5. But sometimes they ask to analyze, sometimes they ask to discuss. In that questions, write in paragraph. If you have certain points to supplement that paragraph, write it in point format. If you have certain diagrams to draw there, draw the diagram. So there is no For me, there is no such differentiation between point format or paragraph format. It is always according to the demand of the question.
What do you think, what strategy is the best for the examination? Self-study, group, or the joint study?
It all depends on one's own nature. The way, means in my first two attempts, I was not studying in a, with my any of my friends because I used to stay alone. But in this attempt for public administration particularly, I had a friend. We used to discuss a lot, and that helped me. That helped me in my mains, and that helped me in my interview also. So if you have a good friend who is as much sincere as you are, it is always helpful, because the kind of syllabus UPSC has, a sincere, hardworking friend always compliment your preparation. But if you have someone who is not so sincere, may always harm you.
What strategy and step did you follow to memorize such a vast syllabus? Because CSE has a very vast syllabus.
Again, this thing, like CSE has a very vast syllabus. Students should also not think about these things, because if you look at the paper, syllabus is not as vast as it looks. Like, as an administrator, you should know many things. But as a aspirant for a particular exam, you should know the demand of that examination. No amount of knowledge can be sufficient for this examination. But again, so much knowledge can be dangerous.
How important is the personal insight and knowledge in writing an answer in the mains examination?
Sorry?
How is it the personal insight and the knowledge in writing the mains examination?
Writing mains examination is as much difficult as preparing for this examination. For that 5 days, physically, mentally, you will be very much tired. So, but in the end, it is always a fun. If you are writing examination, if you are able to complete the paper, the kind of questions they ask, that itself give you a different insight. This time they asked a question which was something which when after reading that question, I was so happy that UPSC has asked this kind of question which I had never thought, but it was happening every day with me. So writing UPSC examination is a great thing. Means if someone is writing, he must be learning from the examination also.
Professional profile of the candidate during the interviews.
Again, if you look at the examination, the final result, you will see students from every community, every place, every section of society clear this examination. So I don't think background of a candidate actually affects interview. If you have knowledge, if you have right attitude, if you have right values, interview is not a that tough process.
Do you think that all the time, years, hard work, sacrifice and struggle that went into preparing for CBSE was worth the effort of all of it?
Yes, certainly. The thing is, this exam is different from other exams, or this exam is called as mother of all exams. There are good reasons for this. When I started preparing, I am from Bihar, and I was studying something about Gujarat. I was studying something about Kashmir. Sometimes I was studying about Russia. So just sitting in a single room with a lot of books, I was imagining many things about the world. So if you will take this exam as a source of happiness, this exam will give you. Means a small boy from a small town reading something about 5,000 years ago, then predicting future of Indian economy, thinking like that gives happiness. So preparing this exam itself is a great source of motivation.
Did you attend any coaching institute, and how is prepared for the interviews?
For interview, I again joined mock interviews at some CULP and Chronicle. Then I went through all my background details, because in UPSC interview, they ask questions related to your background. They check whether you are not just studying the things, you are how good you are at absorbing the things from your surroundings, from your school, from your college. So we need to focus on each and every aspect of that DAF, that detailed application form which we fulfill, and practicing on those things, always keeping the purpose of this service will help in interview.
Who was the chairman of the board and how long was your interview?
Mr. Sri Vinay Mittal was my chairman of my board, and interview was about 30 minutes, 25 to 30 minutes.
Share your experience, what kind of question was asked, and the interviewing client, was their personal life, professional life, what kind of the interview?
And the board was very cordial. Sri Vinay Mittal sir and other members were also very cordial. And I have graduated from Shastra University, Tanjore, Tamil Nadu, and I was born and brought up in district of Bihar. So my first question was related to how did you go from Bihar to Tamil Nadu, then why did you go, what kind of differences you find in the society in Bihar and Tamil Nadu. Then they also asked me facts about that. Like I said, sir, these are the differences, like on social scale, on education sector, on industrial sector. I told about the differences, then they asked me about the facts relative to that. Then they asked me the reasons behind why there is so much of migration, not of labors, but of students also from Bihar to other states. Then they asked me some conceptual questions on defense, Make in India, Digital India, then India-China relation. Then they asked me questions about my hobby, that is cooking and playing and watching cricket. Then there were questions on AFSPA. Then there were questions related to my graduation, that is computer science. More number of questions were from that sector because they wanted to test whether I still remember those things or not. And in the era of digital, we have a program called Digital India, and with my background, I should be able to think about that. So they checked all these aspects. Then they always check personality traits. We need to be humble, polite, always keep constitutional values in our mind, and always remember that those are the people who are much senior to us, who have a lot of experience of public sectors. We cannot take risk of lying to them. They are people of very high knowledge. So people should be humble. Do not bluff. Be to yourself. Thank you.
Thank you.